By the end of this video, you will master these three pleated tools, such as the pleat tool, the pleat fold tool, and the pleat sewing tool in Close 3D. We will also be creating multiple fabrics to making the pleated patterns, then improving the pleated quality and ready to make amazing garments just like these. An evening dress, backless with front pleated, a back pleated skirt with yoke, and more. Are you ready? Let's do it. So after that, I'm going to merge these pattern pieces together. To merge the pattern pieces together, guys, you must be on this edit pattern tool or it doesn't work. Okay, so edit pattern tool, click on it. Then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. And I'm going to marquee select these two edges. And then you see these yellow highlighted appear. I'm going to just hover the mouse over that yellow highlighted and then right click and select merge. Just like that. I'm going to do the same right here. Once again, CLO try to help us by left all the pattern selected. We don't want that. We just want to click one on the page to my key select. Choose me to deselect. Then we're going to my key select just the edge together. Then hover the mouse over that yellow line, right click and select merge. Okay, so as you can see, we just merged these pattern pieces to one. However, there's something we need to do before we complete. So if I click one on the page to deselect, and if I zoom in a little bit, you see right here, have the blue line rather than red line. Blue line is the guideline, red line means the internal line. For the pleat to work, we need to create internal line. And to do that, once again, just use the polygon slash line tool. I'm going to press down letter G on the keyboard to get that tool. And then I'm going to click one right there to start. And I'm going to just hover down because it already have a guide and have a point, which is easy. We're not gonna mess it up. So I'm going to click on that point right there twice to place that internal line. I will do the same right here. Because we merged three patterns together, we will need two internal lines right there. Okay, so next we're going to come down here and repeat the step. Merge the pattern together and create internal lines for each pattern part that we merge, okay? Once again, I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool, then select this edit pattern, and then marquee select. You can marquee or click one right here and then press down shift on the keyboard to click another one, and then now I can hover the mouse over the highlighted area and then right click and select merge. I'm going to do the same right here, click one right there and then press down shift and click on this edge of the pattern, right click and then merge. Okay, so next we are going to create the internal line for this right here and for this right here. Let's just click one on the page to deselect, then I'm going to come over here to this 2D toolbar and select this internal polygon slash line tool to select. Then I'm going to click one to start and just hover the mouse down here and then click twice to end. I'm going to do the same right here and then come down here. Okay, it looks pretty good. So I'm going to come over here to this edit pattern tool once again, click on it, guide to select. Then I'm going to pan it down a little. We want to merge these pattern pieces together. Once again, click one, press down shift, click the next pattern, right click, and select merge. The same with here, click one to start, and then press down shift and click the next pattern. then right click and then select merge. Okay, next I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. Then I'm going to press down letter G on the keyboard to get the internal polygon slash line tool and click one to start. Then click twice to end. Click one to start. Click twice to end. Okay, let me zoom back out and pan it down a little. So as you can see right here, we just create a pleated pattern. Next, we are going to use this pleat fold tool, guys. It's awesome. Okay, so this tool right here, okay, so come to this 2D toolbar, click on it, and you see right here, pleat fold tool, click on it. So this pleat fold tool, when we click one right here to start, and then click twice right here to end, after we click it twice, this pleat fold window pop up, and we have a choice. You can either select knife pleats or box pleats or accordion pleats. For this example, I'm going to select box pleats, okay? Then reverse direction, we don't want it. We want number of internal line per pleat 3 and fold angle 0 to 360, outside fold 0, inside fold 360. That's perfect. So to understand this, guy, if we don't use this pleat folding tool, we have to go in and try to fold, adjust this fold angle one by one, which is a pain in the rear. We don't want that. So this pleat tool allow us to click one, three clicks, okay? Then we create the perfect fold for a pleated. Next, I'm going to come down here, click on OK. Okay. Next, I'm going to repeat the step with this one. So I'm going to click one to start and then click twice to bring this pleat fold window. And I'm going to check on the box pleats again. And then number of internal line per pleat, 3, fold angle 0 to 360, outside fold 0, inside fold 360, then click on OK. Okay, so as you can see, the one that we did the pleats fold have different color compared to the one that we not yet do the pleats fold. So I'm going to repeat the step with this one as well. So click one to start and then click twice to end. Then these pleats fold window pop up. I'm going to click on that box pleats and number of internal line per pleat 3 and fold angle 0 to 360 and outside fold 0, inside fold 360. Then I'm going to click on OK to confirm. Okay, that is so cool, guys. So next, I'm going to strengthen these pattern pieces, okay? So strengthen the pattern pieces will give us this pleat effect that we want, okay? You must strengthen these pattern pieces first. So it gives us less collision, plus it gives us this fold sharpness that we want to strengthen the pattern. Once again, I'm going to come over here to this. This tool is really useful, guys. This transform pattern tool, we always use that tool over and over. Click on that to select. Shortcut key for that is letter A. Or another tip that I want to point out here, if you press command or control plus letter A on your keyboard, you select all these pattern pieces. That's what we want. All I need to do now, just hover the mouse over that pattern, right click, and select strengthen right there. Perfect. So as you can see right now, all the pattern pieces turn yellow except the one that we freeze, but that's okay. Okay, so next I'm going to click one on the page to deselect. I'm going to sew these pleats pattern onto these pattern pieces. To do that, we are going to use this amazing tool right there in here. Just click on that pleats tool and then come to this pleats sewing tool. Click on it. Okay, I'm going to start from the bottom first. So we are going to sew the single top piece first. Click one to start. Click once again to end that sewing. Then I'm going to click one with this pleat sewing pattern. And I'm going to just hover the mouse over to the right. And then click one to end the pleat sewing. So as you can see right here, now this pleat is sewing to this top part right there. The same as here. I'm going to repeat the step with this pattern here. So click one to start. Click once again to end. Click one to start, hover the mouse over to the right, and then click once again to end. We just sew the part two. And right here, I'm going to once again, click right here, click right here to start, hover the mouse over to the right, and then click once again to end. Okay, so next I'm going to switch my tool back to transform pattern tool. Then I'm going to press the space bar on the keyboard to simulate. That is really cool, guy. Okay, I just pressed on the space bar one again to stop the simulation. Okay, so next I'm going to zoom in to this 3D window. And as you can see, a pleat don't look that good. That's okay. We can fix that. So there are something that we can fix these pleats, okay? Depend on how big the fabric that you are using. For this example, the fabric not so big. So I want to show you this. So with this skirt right here, all this skirt right here, I have the particle distance 2.7, the same as here. To give this smooth look, as well as, let me get this bigger one. See right here? To give this smooth look, and I also have this thickness of rendering to 1.5. I also darken the yoke to make this split more pop, okay? Okay, so this is better. You see right here, the pleat is really crisp and smooth. That's what we want. So it's depend on how big your computer is. The particle distance is slow down your computer if you like keep decreasing. I tried it fine and almost like really freeze my laptop. So I just started with 10, then it still doesn't look that crisp. So I decreased the particle distance to 7 and it looks all right. That's why I stop at 7, because again, I work on my laptop. It could be really intense for the rendering process. However, this is also another important right here. You see this line right there? It's smooth. That because all this sewing line right here turn curved. Sometimes, even though we use this automatic, let me get back to a pleat right here. Even though we use this pleat sewing tool, sometimes it doesn't really give us all these line sewing turn to curve, but I will show you in a bit, okay? All right, so as you can see, we just finished sewing a pleat right here, right here, right here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, Designistas. If you find this video useful, remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Love it. Thanks, guys.